Welcome to Jay and Kenya's weight loss journey, real life. This is episode 24.
Hello.
And today's topic is about dieting and dining out. I have a lot of clients that dine out. We dine out, we eat out often, some more than others. We know it can be very difficult. And so on this episode, we're going to provide you guys with hopefully some helpful ideas to help you along your journey. All right? Stay tuned. Jay's going to provide you with what not to do, okay?
Basically, because I ain't got no idea. I ain't got no tips other than stay away.
My first suggestion would be to know what your daily caloric intake and carbohydrate intake should be. And so basically for like myself, I try to stay at a daily intake of 1,200 calories a day and 50 to 100 grams of carbs a day. Jay
needs to track. That's what Jay needs to do, track his food. Because my calories, I don't keep up with them. I don't keep up with my carbs. So this week, I got to do something different.
Alrighty then.
Okay, so Jay's intake should be about 2,000 calories per day and 100 and 150 grams a day. So let's just focus on what I do. And I do track a lot and I do food photos as well too. With knowing your daily caloric goal, that will help you make the right food choices when you're looking at that menu.
Yeah, one combo from one of them fast food restaurants already hits that 1,100 calories.
It sure does. It can.
So, yeah.
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 Welcome to Good Burger, home of the Good Burger. Can I take your order?
I'll have two number nines, a number nine large, a number six with extra dip, a number seven, two number 45s, one with cheese, and a large soap.
Next, you're going to take that number, your daily caloric intake, and you're going to divide it by three. Three being particularly the amount of meals that you eat in a day. So I try to get three meals in a day. So divide that by three. That's 400 calories per meal. Now, we have flexibility with that, but on average, we're going to say I have 400 calories to eat out with. Let's just say this is a lunch meal that I'm eating out with. Yesterday, my son and I went to the Cheesecake Factory, and I was looking for a 400-calorie meal on the menu. Most menus display the caloric intake, right? So we're going to base our choices off of the caloric intake. So 400 calories per meal is what I have to work with. Now, if you've noticed, eating out, most meals, that's double, triple in calories, higher in fat, carbs, sugars, sodium, everything. All right? So just dining out, it is much more difficult. I do encourage people to dine out less. Eat at home more. Because you can make those wonderful, delicious meals at home and save a lot of calories and carbs, fat, sodium. You won't have to use so much. So my suggestion is, like for my 400 calorie meal, looking at a menu, you know, it may be difficult. So what I saw, for example, at the Cheesecake Factory, I wound up getting the like pot stickers. They were like 410 calories for five pot stickers. But what I did prior to, and these are my suggestions for you, okay? I drank two glasses of water. I did indulge in some bread. I drank the water first, but I did account for that. But I was accounting that I was going to do some exercise to help burn that off. Now, let me finish here. I suggest that you try to eat, drink a high protein snack or either drink a protein shake or eat a high protein snack before looking at the menu and choosing something or eating. Wearing a binder. Guys can wear binders as well too, but sometimes women, we wear a lot of shape body shapers, and binders is natural for us to do that. Or you wear pants that pull your pants up a little around the waist, and it's just so you can feel a little bit more restriction around the stomach area. So you can wind up eating less. It's just a, you know, something that you can naturally easily do. And yeah, sometimes we want to pull our pants down so we can feel more comfortable with eating. But sometimes maybe you just put yourself in a state of feeling uncomfortable so you can wind up eating less.
I'm just saying, I don't need to go. I mean, if you don't choose well, you know, you make one bad mistake on Monday, figure it's already a mistake, so you might as well, you know, compound it on Tuesday. You'll make up for it on Wednesday. My suggestion is prepare your foods at home, because a salad, you know, with dressing is a lot of carbs, a lot of calories. So I'm making my meals at home. Salad!
Choose a meal if you decide to choose a meal. So for example, I think there was maybe a meal that might have been, let's just say 800, 900 calories. But my son didn't want to eat it with me. Okay. I could have asked for a to-go box automatically. Chose that 800 calorie meal, even though it's higher than the calories that I need, I could go ahead and just ask for my to-go box. When my meal comes, go ahead and automatically cut my meal in half, close it up, put it away so I'm not looking at it, put it either on my seat, out of sight, and go ahead and just enjoy my meal, eat slowly, and that's the 400 calories for that lunchtime, you know, lunch portion, okay? Or if the other person is willing to share a meal. Remember we used to share our meals, Jay? We used to do the bone-in.
I was asking for, you know, crisp chicken to share. You could have cut it in half and brought me some home, but, you know, I ain't getting no crisp chicken from
the Cheesecake Factory. Okay, so we'll talk about that later.
I shared a meal. See if he needs the crispy chicken. I shared a meal, but, you know, I mean, it is what it is.
My other suggestions for dining out is always take food photos and use a food tracker to log them in. Guys, I'm going to tell you what happened. We were out at Crabtree Mall in Raleigh. Me and my son, and I had, like I said, we ate at the Cheesecake Factory, and I'm going to tell, after taking food photos, I logged everything in, and I did have 2 loaves of the brown bread. Yeah, I didn't log it until later. I don't think I put the butter in. I don't know if I put this butter in, but at the end of the day, and we went to Chick-fil-A, I got a brownie and I got ice cream. That was like 500 calories. By the end of the day yesterday, I was at 2,810 calories, 400 grams of carbs. I'm blown away, like, OMG. I gotta get on the grind this morning. Like, I had to work out, like, when I got home yesterday after that trip, I was out exercising. I was up this morning, 13 miles, you know, it, because I know I had to put in some work, but doing that every day, like, I can't do it. So, you know, you got to know what you can get away with. I can't do it every day.
Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time. Ain't nobody got time. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that.
Obviously, I can't get away with nothing because it's not going in the right direction. That's all I got to say. And maybe I'll be hungry. I don't be that food. I'll be like, the food already hot. I don't want to get cold, taking a picture at. And normally it's in a bag because it's some type of fast food on the go. So I just need to do better. I don't know what to say. Just real life, this stuff sucks. Mm-hmm. I just gotta do better.
All right, check your menus online prior to dining out. This is to avoid delays in ordering. Sometimes if you're with a group of people, you may feel a little, you know, weird about ordering, like taking the time, looking at the menu, looking at calories and pulling up stuff. So I do suggest that you try to look up on the menu prior to going out, okay? Other suggestions would be to, like Jay was mentioning about the salad. Salads are wonderful options for people. They're very healthy. It depends on what you put on your salad. Use a light dressing. You can ask for a light dressing. I put a lot of different things on my salads, but ultimately it's a better option than some of this high fat fried foods, you know, high sodium. It just depends on what you're doing, but you can always ask for light dressings. Okay. Choose a grilled option instead of a fried option. You have something to say?
No, I'm just here thinking about all the stuff that I don't do that you do.
Well, I mean, it takes some time. It didn't happen overnight, but if you want to change the lifestyle,
even when I choose a salad, like I mess up on the dressing. I don't even put a lot of stuff on my salad.
It's not right. It's the dressing that might get it.
I put cheese and put dressing up.
Cheese and dressing. That's exactly right.
My supposedly healthy salad done turned into like 1,200 calories. Just like that for one meal. And I think I done great, but I haven't.
Choose chicken, fish, turkey instead of like red meat. So instead of pork and beef, because the pork and the beef has a lot more calories and lots more fat. Okay.
No kidding. I'm just here thinking. I just messed up. I'm good. Keep rolling.
If you must have a dessert, try to choose a fruit. You know, something pretty light. Or you can split a dessert. Like sometimes, like, oh my gosh, those at the Cheesecake Factory, some of those desserts were like 1,500 calories, like for my whole day. I was like, oh no. And I'm glad it is displayed there for, you know, public health safety awareness. So we can know now what the calories is. Cause it was like, that is crazy. But even to split it in half, it was crazy. That's a lot.
Hey, look, when you're my size, you can't cheat like that, you know, because a cinnamon roll hurts you.
You can't cheat like what?
I mean, you can cheat.
When you your size.
But when you my size, you eat a cinnamon roll, you're trying to lose weight, that cinnamon roll puts you back. That cinnamon roll turns
that into cinnamon, a that, cookie. That could put me back two pounds. What are you talking about?
It turns you into a cookie and a whole bunch of other stuff.
When like, you any size, it's going to put you back. It's about which exercise or what you're going to do with it the next day or how often you keep doing it. I did it one day. And I gained 2 pounds the next day, and I bust my butt 13 miles the next day to work it off. So it doesn't matter what size you are.
I mean, okay.
Next, suggestions. Avoid dipping sauce and try to do dry rubs, okay? Instead of like the really saucy, like honey barbecue, sweet baby rays. I love me some sweet baby rays. Dipping sauce. Those things are going to have a lot more sugar in it and calories and carbs. When dining out, try to get a sugar-free soda.
Nope. Drink water. Don't even try the soda. Diet soda ain't no better substitute than regular soda. Because it don't ever get you back in that trap. Because as soon as you get the regular soda or diet, it don't taste good and you want some sugar.
Okay. Try sugar-free soda. Crystal Light packs are great. Crush packs, there's different sugar-free packs that you can keep in. I like to keep some of those things in my purse and ask for water when I'm at a restaurant. And basically what, you know, because sometimes the restaurants just have like Diet Pepsi or Diet Coke or something. And I don't like those things. And so I just have my own, okay? And for every alcoholic beverage you drink, try to drink 1 to 2 glasses of water with that, okay? To make sure you stay hydrated and don't dehydrate yourself.
It's real simple. Know yourself. I eat out too much because enough meals ain't made at the house. So I eat out, and when I eat out, I grab those convenient stuff plus the snack to go along with it, all right? So I need to stop eating out 2 to 3. I was supposed to not eat out but once a day.
My
but I eat out 2 to 3 times a day.
Meals is always cooked at the house. You just don't take them with him. You just don't take the food to work with him. That is as simple as that. He wants to eat out every day.
I don't like leftovers.
So, now it's time for the couples challenge.
You see how I feel today, right?
You can keep feeling how you want to feel. You can keep me feeling all you want.
Gotta be real with it.
I ain't no feelings. I'm just saying. See how I'm feeling right now. I ain't winning right now.
Okay, you ain't winning, so just get over it.
I ain't talking about winning the game. I'm talking about winning. I can't win. I ain't winning right now.
Because you just need to change it and move on. Okay, stop soaking.
I ain't soaking. Keep moving.
What we doing then? What we doing right now?
I'm waiting for you to go ahead and keep going.
Gotta be real with it.
So Jay's weight last week was 290.4?
Yeah, that's what it was.
This week, Jay's weight was 292.2. Jay gained 1.8 pounds this week, which was 0.6% of his body weight. Let's go ahead and put the money in the pot right now.
No, go ahead and tell your weight. Go on and tell your weight.
No, let's go and put your weight. We both got to pay the pot anyway.
Go ahead.
All right. My weight last week was 162.4 pounds. My weight this week was 161.0 pounds. I lost 1.4 pounds, which was 0.9% of my body weight. Thank you. This was cycle week for me, so, and I did decide to take my Topiramate this week. Did it help on Friday? Heck no. I don't think it just stopped anything in my cravings. I just ate what I wanted to, I guess. But ultimately, I did. My physical activity, I think, definitely has been helping a lot here, guys, truly lately. And I've been really grateful for that. So, I will say I average 20,000 at least steps a day, which is way beyond. So I'm averaging 10 miles a day. Okay. So I will say that walking, and I've enjoyed it morning and afternoon. So that's outside of the normal from when I started this journey. Jay did not lose his weight, so he owes $10, and I'm going to take out, because I won this week. I'm going to take out my 20. This is your 20. I'm taking your 20, and so I get paid. All right. But touching back on what Jay was saying, I do believe, for most people that's trying to lose weight, really limit eating out. For most of my clients, I've said this to you guys, try to do one. Everybody is different. If you eat out every day, I tell you, try just 4 days a week or 3 days a week. And then try to continue to decrease that. Find meals that are very easy and quick and convenient at home to try to do, because there's just so many more calories that's packed into these foods, and it's just not conducive to weight loss. Know what your limit is. For me, I'm just noticing I can only probably get away with eating out twice a week. If that much, but it's like if I do it on the weekends, it almost undo my whole week of the weight loss that I've lost, and it's like then I gotta start back over through the whole week and do this. It's this vicious cycle. So one day is usually enough for me to, and I pack my meals every day. I hope my husband, I want him to do well. I want him to win. I want to get this pot now. Do I want him to win the whole thing? I want him to lose weight. I want him to beat me, but no. I want him to do well and make this an easy transition in lifestyle, but I know it's difficult for him. He's got to find his fit And, you know, it's going to take some time. Like I tell you guys, lifestyle changes take a lifetime to learn sometimes. And but you got to learn yourself. It's sacrifices we got to make. Anything?
Only thing I got to say, this ain't easy. You know, nothing about it is easy. You know, trying to figure out foods that you consistently like or eat that's less than 400 calories is difficult because it don't taste that good. Depends on the choices.
That's 400 for me.
No, I'm talking about if I only got 2,000 calories, that ain't too much different per meal from doing three meals a day.
That's...
If one of my meals is 1,100, if I eat out...
675 or 50?
If I eat out, it's 1,100 as far as different things, as far as, you know, most of them fried, though. As far as chicken, fried chicken from somewhere or something like that. Well, if I get a soda, it's automatically bad. A small bag of chips is about 150 calories. You know, it's just bad choices. So the best thing for me to do, or I suggest to you, is if you ain't that strong to not go in the store and get these items, just don't go to the store. Right? Make something simple at the house. Stay away from the breads. Because it don't help, especially if you want to have your cheese. And that's about it. So just keep trying hard. It's going to get that. You got some ups and downs, but keep working at it. And, you know, I ain't going to get to no, you know, 10 miles a day, but I might do 6, 5, 4.5, maybe. So around there.
Okay.
You know what I mean? 10. I mean, I'm at 10 now. I'm at 13.
Thank you guys for watching. Please share, like, and subscribe, and leave your comments.
Pray for me. That's simple. Pray for me.
If you guys have some tips, ideas, please, you know, share it with us, too. What do you guys do? Let us know. We would love to know what you guys are doing. Or, you know, maybe give us some, you know, pointers on what you think we can do, too. I like to share with my clients as well, too. You guys help me. Help others. So we look forward to seeing you next week and have a great day.
Take it easy.